Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How's everybody?
Blessed and highly favored.
Amen?
Amen.
Everybody has a power to choose, right?
Amen.
So you can either be miserable or joyful.
Amen.
You can either submit or resist.
Amen.
You can either sow or not sow. You can either sow to the flesh and reap corruption, or you can sow to the spirit and reap life. God has given every one of us the power to choose. Amen? So whose choice is it?
Ours.
God will never force us to do anything. Not that he doesn't want to kick us in the butt sometimes. Glory, lift your hands to heaven and ask him for more. Lord, we want more of you. More, and more. We have entered a season. It is so powerful. It's phenomenal. I mean, it's overwhelmingly exciting.
Amen.
I mean, to God be the glory.
Amen.
The Antichrist was kicked out of the White House. Amen. The Spirit of Christ is in there. And exposure is manifesting all over, not only the country, but I want you to know that there's a revelation. There's revolution of revelation that is spreading globally.
Amen.
I'm telling you, globally. Why? Because this is a preparation for the final harvest.
Amen.
The word says something powerful. The Lord says, my gospel, my truth must be preached in every part of the globe. And this is the awakening and the fire that will spread. Because it had to start with a head. Because see, everything comes down from the head.
Amen.
And when the head of a country has a desire to please God and seek God, it begins to spread.
Amen.
One of the things that happens is because the Christ, the anointing that's within the individual, desires to not only know truth, love truth, practice truth, decree truth, and spread the truth. And truth is light.
Amen.
And light always exposes darkness. So you're going to see a flame that's going to spread through the whole country and then globally. Has everybody got it? I'm telling you, globally. It's a revolution of revelation.
Amen.
Oh, glory. Let's go to Revelation chapter 1 while we're in there. Revelation chapter 1. And the price, there is a price that we must pay every day. What's it called? Cooperation is the price. You're not willing to cooperate, you don't advance. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus gave us the formula, deny yourself. Pick up the sword, pick up the cross, and what? Follow. There is no victory without a battle. Amen? Every victory comes with a battle. And we are in a war. And the war is not physical, it's spiritual. And the moment you lose focus of that, you've lost. Amen?
Amen.
The moment you lose focus that your influence is from the unseen realm, you just lost the battle. Revelation 1 and verse 9. Let's speak it, because what we speak is what we eat, and what we eat is what we become. So one of the things the devil doesn't want you to do is sing or sow out of your mouth. Why? Because he can keep you bound. And you got to remember that people have demons.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
And those demons don't want you to sing, because you know what begins to happen? You begin to eat light. Those demons don't want to leave you. And I don't care if you've been proclaimed Christian of 30 years. If you can't sow, you're demonized. Hello? Has everybody got it?
Amen.
In verse 9, let's speak it. I, John, both your brother and companion in the tribulation and kingdom and patience of Jesus Christ, was on the island that is called Patmos for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus Christ. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a loud voice as of a what? A trumpet. I love it. Saying what? I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last. what you see, write in a book and send it to the seven churches which are in Asia, to Ephesus, Samaria, Pergamos, to Thyatira, Samaria, Sardis, to Philadelphia, and to Laodicea. Then I turned to see the voice that spoke with me. Having turned, I saw seven golden lampstands, and in the midst of the seven lampstands, one like the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the feet, and girded about the chest with a golden band. His head and hair were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes like a flame of fire. Now, this is Jesus. This is what he looks like now. His feet were like fine brass as it refined in furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. He had in his right hand seven stars, and out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword. And his countenance was like the sun shining in its strength. And when I saw him, I fell at his feet as dead. But he laid his hand right on me, saying to me, "Do not be afraid. I am the first and the last. I am he who lives and was dead. Behold, I am alive forever. Amen. And I have the keys of Hades and of death." Write, everyone say write.
Right.
Write the things which you have seen, the things which are, and the things which will take place after this. Write. Does everybody understand? Write. I want you to grab hold of something, because this is what was happening. The Lord was saying, I want you to write this information that I am showing you, that you are experiencing. Why? Because these are going to be letters that I am sending to my body, my church. Now, at that time, there were seven churches that were established. And in that, the number seven means complete and perfect. So there are seven messages, one to every church. Some of them were lukewarm. Some of them lost their first love. The Lord corrected every one of the churches. But at the end of every message and letter that he gave him, he said, "He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says." Because it was the Spirit that was causing a man to write what he was hearing, what he was seeing, and what he was experiencing. Does everybody got that? And this is important, because that's what God is doing again right now. 2 Corinthians 3. Hallelujah. Man, there's so many things that are going on, and it's incredible. I mean, it's just blowing my mind. Things that we thought, you know, that we heard about are now coming to light. There's so many changes right now. Things have been shut down. No more UN. UN is getting kicked out. Amen. We're not paying their rent no more. We're done paying with them. All the trade stuff has been stopped. There's no more hiring for a government. And they raided the office, the FBI raided the office of the Center for Disease Control, because they believe that they've been putting bad stuff in vaccinations, causing harm. Now, you got to understand that the United States is the main distributor for all vaccinations globally. So you got children with all kinds of diseases and all effects. And then it gets inherited and comes down. These are things that are happening. Why? Because darkness is being exposed, and it's going to be exposed globally. And those that want to continue to expose the powers of darkness globally will join the United States. United States will be great again in preparation for the largest harvest and the return of the Lord.
Amen.
And you're either walking with it or you're not.
Amen.
Amen? Oh, glory. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 1. Let's speak it together. Do we begin again to commend ourselves, or do we need, as others, epistles of commendation to you, or letters of commendation from you? For you are what? Our epistle, written in our hearts, known and read by all men. Clearly you are an epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but by the what? By the Spirit of the living God. On tablets of stone, not on tablets of stone, but at what? On the tablets of flesh, that is what? It is your heart. And we have such trust through Christ towards God, not that we are what? Sufficient of ourselves to think of anything as being from ourselves, but our sufficiency is from God, who also made us sufficient as ministers of the new covenant, not of the letter, but of the Spirit, for the letter kills, and the Spirit does what? The Spirit brings life. We are epistles of truth. Everyone say, I'm the epistle of the truth. In other words, you are the same letter that has been written to the seven churches. It's been written in you now. You are the epistle. You are the letter that God is sending out to the world. Everyone say, I'm the epistle of the truth. I am the letter of the truth written by the Holy Spirit. Why? Because we are to bring life, new life. You are called to bring new life, a new covenant, and a new identity to mankind. And it's not really, it's new to them, but it's always been. It's always been. That's why the word says you must be born of the Spirit of God. Not born of the flesh or the will of man, but you must be born of the Spirit of God. There's a born-again experience that occurs when you are baptized in the Holy Spirit. Is everybody okay? Ephesians 1. Turn to your neighbor and tell him you're an epistle of the truth. Yes. So we need to stop acting like idiots, right? Amen. Or people that know what the heck. Ephesians chapter 1 and verse 13. Let's speak it. In him you also trusted after you heard the what? The what? The word of truth. The gospel of your salvation. And whom also, having believed, you were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise, who is the guarantee of our inheritance until the redemption of the purchased possession to the praise of his glory. You and I, we are to be sealed. See, when a letter goes out, when the king sends the letter out, he seals it with the king's seal. That's why we are to be sealed. Because we are now the epistle of truth. Not by anything, but by the Holy Spirit. It's been written. It's in me and you. It is the regeneration that begins to happen by the Holy Spirit in me and you. If you cooperate. If you do not cooperate, it ain't going to happen. Cooperation is the key. You can cry all you want. And you can do all kinds of things, but God ain't moving until you cooperate. Has everybody got it? When you cry, he puts you in a place. He says, here, learn. Because I love you. When you cry out to God, Lord, Lord, that's called mercy. What you're asking to do is consider me. Please consider me. Please. He says, I consider you. I got you. That's mercy. He picks you up. He says, now go learn grace. Let me introduce you to grace. Grace is the plan of God to escape. It's to escape, first of all, the deception of the devil and the wrath of God. Because if you can't escape the deception of the devil, you're falling into the wrath of God. Amen? Oh, glory. So you and I, this is powerful. We are the letter of truth, the epistle of the truth, sealed by the King of the Holy Spirit. So why? We can be sent out. James chapter 1. How many of y'all know there's preparation before sending? Amen. Because God ain't going to send you to represent you. He sends you to represent him. James James chapter 1 and verse 16. It's a revolution of revelation. People are awakening. But you got to remember something. We talked about this already. There's going to be tremendous resistance. Every demon in hell is coming out using a voice of a human who will let them to rebel, to lie, to do everything they can to prevent the move of God. But let me tell you, when daddy's on a roll, ain't nothing going to stop. Verse 16, let's grow for it. Do not be what?
Deceived.
Do not be what?
Deceived.
Do not be what?
Deceived.
Do not be deceived, my beloved brethren. Every good gift and every precious gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow of turning. Of his own will, he brought us forth from, by the what?
Word.
By the word of truth. Remember, if you're an epistle of truth, the word is truth, isn't it?
Amen.
Amen. So you and I were brought by the word of truth that we might be a kind of first fruits of his creatures, that we might be the expression of his character by the divine nature in me and you. So then, my beloved brethren, let every man be what? Swift to hear and slow to speak, slow to wrath, for the wrath of man does not produce the righteousness of God. Therefore, do what? Lay aside all what? Filthiness and overflow of wickedness, and receive with meekness the implanted word. Receive with meekness the implanted word. That means you must be humble to accept it. Which is able to what? Save your souls. But be what? Doers. Let me tell you something. It's do not try. Never try. Do. Oh, I'm going to try. Oh, shut up. Triers are wimps. Those are the ones that always say, I'm going to try. That means they ain't going to do it. See, they already made the excuse they're not going to do it. Because then they can use the excuse, well, I tried. See, they already lost. Has everybody got it? They already lost the battle. I'm going to try. Oh, weenie. You didn't try when you were out there drinking and partying. You didn't try when you were hunting the opposite sex. You did. You doo-doo. You were a doo-doo-doo-doo. Hallelujah. Are you ready? Verse 22, but be what? Be what?
Doers.
Doers of the word, of the truth, and not hearers only, deceiving yourself. For if anyone is a hearer of the word and not a doer, he's an idiot. He is like a man observing his natural face in a what? Mirror. For he observes himself, goes away, and immediately forgets what kind of man he was. In other words, his identity was stolen. But he looks in the perfect law of liberty and does what? And does what?
Continues,
maintains in it, and is not a forgetful hero, but a doer of the work. This one will be what? He'll be what?
Blessed
in what he does. How many of y'all want to be blessed? Then you got to be a doer, not a trier. Oh, snap. Oh, snap. You and I were brought forth by the word of truth. It's been implanted, a planted word, as doers. Amen? We are to become not only workers of the truth, as doers of the truth, but we are to be lovers of the truth. See, if you don't love the truth, then you don't love Jesus. Amen? We're to be lovers of the truth. I love it. We are to express the truth. We are to decree the truth. We are to be followers of the truth. We're to be carriers of the truth because we are the epistles of the truth. Amen? And because of this, we are to be in a position and place of maintaining the truth. By maintaining the truth, you maintain life.
Oh, glory.
By maintaining the truth, you maintain position in relationship with the Lord and the person of the truth. See, because truth is a person, his name is Jesus. So if you don't love the truth, then you don't love Jesus. Amen? In other words, what we do is we build your everything that you and I do should build on truth. If you're not seeking the truth, desire the truth, then there's something wrong with you. You can't be free without the truth. It's impossible. You can do all the rituals you want, but without the truth, you're not going to be free. We can do all the dancing, but see, we cooperate with the truth because the word says that dancing is a weapon. It's a weapon of praise. But some people have never even looked it up. It's in the psalm. Dance. It's a form of worship. Come on, the Indians used to do it all the time. And many people. Look at how many people dance. Now look at if you're sick or whatever, I understand, you know. But you can at least move a foot, you know. Do a little twist. Don't stand there like a dead person. Show some life. Praise God. Ezekiel 3. Ezekiel 3. My buddy Zeke. Oh, glory. God is good all the time. Welcome to Tuesday night training session. It's Tuesday night live. Oh, hallelujah. Ezekiel chapter 3 and verse 1. Let's speak it. Moreover, the Lord said to me, Son of man, eat what you find. And what does he say? Eat this what? What was written on the scroll. Truth. He said, eat the scroll. And go and speak to the house of Israel. How many know God? That's what God is saying now. Eat and speak. So I opened my mouth, and he caused me to eat that scroll. And he said to me, Son of man, feed your belly and fill your stomach with this scroll that I give you. In other words, eat the word. Fill your spirit with the word. So I ate, and it was in my mouth like honey in sweetness. And he said to me, Son of man, go to the house of Israel and speak with my words to them. For you are not sent to a people of unfamiliar speech and hard language, but to those of Israel. Not too many people of unfamiliar speech in a hard language whose words you cannot understand. Surely I have sent you to them. They would have listened to you. But the house of Israel will not listen to you because they will not listen to me. For all the house of Israel are impudent and hard-hearted. See, people with a hardened heart will not hear. They won't receive. What happens is they come but don't do. Because if you truly believe, when you receive, you do it, or else you don't believe it. Amen? All right. Verse 8. Behold, I have made your face strong against their faces and your forehead strong against their foreheads. Like an adamant stone hardened in flint, I had made your forehead. Do not be afraid of them, nor be dismayed at their looks, though they are a rebellious house. Moreover, he said to me, Son of man, receive into your heart all my words that I speak to you, and hear with your ears. This is what he's asking us. And go and get the captives to the children of your people and speak to them and tell them, thus says the Lord God, whether they hear or whether they what?
refuse. Speak to them anyways. And that's what he's saying to me and you. Let me tell you, we're calling those things that are not as though they are. What occurred is right now is by the Spirit of God, through the prophets that prophesied about what has occurred. That was nation, global. And through the Spirit of God, he has set up many to pray and intercede, which just occurred for many years. Does everybody get it? And God fulfilled his own prayer, his own desire through his people. And this is where we are at right now. Does everybody got it? Now, he said, eat the truth, become the truth, decree the truth, because the word of truth is unseen substance. Everyone say unseen substance. That is the word of God. It's unseen substance, but it is a substance that is constant. So we're pulling those things out of the unseen so that it may come through me and you. And when it is spoken, it makes things to become seen. Substance is then created in the physical realm by the unseen realm. But it's got to be God's will. We are the substance of the Word of God, of the Word of truth. You and I are now the substance. Amen? That has become seen. Just like the Word became flesh, right? The Word became flesh and dwelt among men with truth. Now you and I are the written epistle. We are now substance of truth. We are the substance of the Word of God. Why? Because you are born again in the Spirit. And you are now proclaiming the truth. You are walking epistle. If you're doing what you're supposed to do. Does everybody get it? Go to Psalm 15. Psalm 15. So if you believe it, you do it. So we're not trying, we're doers. Just again, like dancing. In Psalm 149, it talks about dance becomes a praise. Worship. Man, you got to get up and worship. You got to worship the Lord. You got to go after him. Why? Because you're sowing. And while you're praising, you're killing yourself. You're denying yourself. See, but fear is what keeps your natural man alive. And we're to be dead to ourselves. Everyone say, dead to myself. Dead to myself. And alive to Christ.
Alive to Christ.
Glory. Psalm 15, verse 1. Who may what? Abide in your tabernacle. That's his presence. Who may dwell in your holy hill? He who walks what? Uprightly. Is that according to truth? Yes. And works what? Righteousness. Is that according to truth? And speaks the truth in his heart. He who does not backbite with his tongue, nor does evil to his neighbor, nor does he take up a reproach against his friend, and whose eyes a vile person is despised. A vile person is a liar anyways. But he honors those who fear the Lord. Why? Because it's truth. He who swears to his own hurt and does not change, he won't change. He who does not put out his money at usury, in other words, doesn't try to manipulate or bribe. Nor does he take a bribe against the innocent. He who does these things shall never be what? He won't be moved. Why? Because he stands and lives in truth. Truth is everything to you. And when truth becomes everything to you, Jesus becomes everything to you. Because they are the same. We're to love truth, become truth, express truth, decree truth, and expose lies. In other words, we are to be honest. Amen? Honest and just. Those that are honest and just will abide in the presence of God. Those that are not will not. 2 Thessalonians 2. Hallelujah. Epistles of truth. At such a time as this, is a global awakening is happening. Hallelujah. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 9. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 9. Again, there is going to be much resistance. There'll be much persecution. But there's going to be a lot of boldness for righteousness. Second Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 9. Let's speak it. The coming of the lawless one is according to the working of Satan with all power, signs, and lying wonders. With all unrighteous what? Deception among those who perish because they did not receive the what? Because they did not receive the what? Love of the truth. Because they did not love the truth. Right? That they might be what? They might be saved. For this reason, God will send them strong delusion. Why? Because they rejected the love. They stopped. They didn't want to love the truth no more. They decided to love themselves more than the truth. And God will allow delusion to come. Why? See, it's not, it says that God will send strong delusion, but reality is this, that the lawless one works with deception. God will use even the enemy. God uses the devil. Does everybody get it? That they should believe the lie, verse 12, that they all may be condemned who did not believe the truth, but had pleasure in what? Pleasure in what? Unrighteousness, but we're not bound to give, but we are bound to give thanks to God always for you, brethren, beloved by the Lord, because God from the beginning chose you. Everyone say, He chose me for salvation through sanctification by the Spirit and belief in the truth. Does everybody get this? Now, if you don't cooperate, can this happen? No. That's what people just don't get. You can be predestined, but you must walk in your predestined call. If you refuse to walk in your predestined call, you don't get it. Oh, the lawlessness is actually a representation of rebellion. It's rebellion against truth. Deception, let me share this with you, is the misleading of the truth into a lie of bondage. That's what deception does. It misleads truth. It manipulates it, counterfeits it. And it causes people to believe something that's not true. And it's actually a lie, and it brings them into bondage because it opens it. See, when you believe in a lie, you touch and agree with evil. Amen. And it opens the door to you. So know that one of the fruits of presence of evil is rebellion. Second Corinthians 4. Second Corinthians 4 and verse 1. What a time we are at. I love it. I mean, it's exciting. It's exciting to watch demons squirm. And they're using all of these people, man. They're coming out from the woodwork, man. All these movie stars that have been demons possessed and musicians and all that. Why? Because they sold their souls out to Satan. They're now Luciferians. You're going to see all the Luciferian agenda come out as much as they can in the media and everything. They're going to lie. They're going to do everything. They're going to manipulate. They're going to do everything they can to prevent the truth from spreading. But the only thing they're doing is exposing them. In verse 1, therefore, since we have this ministry as we have received mercy, we do not lose heart. But we have renounced the hidden things of shame, not walking in craftiness or handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. But if our gospel, now remember, the gospel is going to be preached to the whole world, and it's spreading like fire right now. There's going to be countries that are going to cooperate with the United States. Do you know that in the day of the inauguration of our 45th president, Jesus' name was mentioned more from the government than the last, I can tell you, the last 8 years. I'd probably say the last 20-something years. They placed their hands on a Bible open to specific scriptures that they proclaimed. The name of Jesus, and there was more prayer in this inauguration than there has been in Obama's life. Except for he's praying to the wrong God anyways. Hallelujah. He's praying to some demon. That's why he carries the spirit of Antichrist. Amen? Does everybody understand that? This is not about race, creed, color, or anything. It's about fruits. But, you know, people are deceived. And it's going to happen. But if our gospel, if the epistle, the message of truth is veiled, if it's blinded, it's veiled to those who are what? Perishing. They're going to perish. They're going to be deceived. They're going to be taken out. Whose mind's the god of this age? Who's the god of this age? Satan. Has blinded. Who do not believe, lest the what? The light of the gospel, the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them. Does everybody see this? So who's blinding them? The devil. For we do not preach ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, ourselves your bondservants for Jesus' sake. For it is God who commanded light to what? Shine out of darkness. Who has shown where? In our hearts, the epistle that's written. You are written by the Spirit of the living God. To give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels that the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us. Look at what it says. It says we're hard pressed. Hello. On every side, yet not crushed. We're hard pressed. We're perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our body. Yes. So your trials and tribulations is doing nothing but manifesting Christ. If you're allowing it. Unless you give in to all of them. If you give in to all of them, then you're manifesting the wrong dude. Amen. Again, don't try, do. John 8. Triers become criers. Doers become dangerous. Yes. John 8:42. Jesus said to them, if God were your Father, you would love me. If you love Jesus, you love the truth. Has everybody got it? You cannot love Jesus without loving truth. It's impossible. For I proceed forth and came from God, nor have I come of myself, but he sent me. Why do you not understand my speech? Because you're not able to listen to my word or truth. You are of your what? Father, the who? The devil. In other words, you have not been unplugged from the world, and you're still an offspring of the devil. You're not born again yet. You are of your father, the devil, and the desires of your father you want to do. He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth because there is no truth in him. When he speaks a lie, he speaks from his own resources, for he is a liar and the father of it. But because I tell the truth, you do not believe me. Which of you convicts me of sin? And if I tell the truth, why do you not believe me? He who is of God hears God's words. Therefore, you do not hear because you're not of God. Has everybody got it? You don't hear because you're not his. You're still yours. Oh, glory. The devil is a liar. Those under his influence of demon forces, they hate the truth. Has everybody got it? They hate the truth. But we are truth carriers. Amen? They will lie to prevent and so forth. They desire to kill. Let me tell you, they hate you. And you can see it all over. There is so much hatred. You know, they talked about hate crime. They're the ones that spoke it, and they're the ones that are doing it. Hallelujah. Isaiah 55. Glory. Isaiah 55 and verse 10. Is everybody there? Let's speak it. For as the rain comes down and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the earth and make it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. Oh, so as you eat the scroll, because what you speak is what you eat. What you eat is you become. What's he doing? He's going to send you. Thank God you don't have to return void. He's going to send you. See, so if you know things prosper because you're in divine order. You're in divine position. He's sending you and it's going to prosper. If it's not prospering, there's something wrong. Amen. If there's no growth, there's something wrong. Remember, we are in a time right now, it is a revolution of revelation. I am telling you, it's happening. God is awakening. People are being exposed. And one of the things that's happening is people that are being exposed, many of them are repenting and turning, realizing that they've been deceived their whole life. That was one of my overwhelming arenas when I had my visitation from the Lord. I was like, I've been lied to my whole life. I've been lied to my whole life. My parents, everyone. Many preachers. I didn't know. Because they didn't know the truth. They didn't do it on purpose. But they didn't know the truth themselves. They were all about religion. Religion don't free you. And Jesus ain't about religion. He hates religion. That's why he rebuked the Pharisees and Sadducees. They were sad, weren't they? Sadducee. John 14. Because they missed the truth. Can you imagine realizing that the whole time it was God Almighty that was in front of you? How about the dudes that whipped him? How about the ones that nailed him to the cross? How about the Pharisees and Sadducees that he called devils? And I realized, and the word says that many who pierced him will see and repent. And they will be pierced themselves. John 14, 16. And Jesus said, and I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper, that he may what? Abide with you forever. He is called the what? Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive. Does everybody get it? Why can't they receive it? Because they ain't been unplugged yet. They haven't repented. Because the Spirit will not, he'll draw you. He'll try to draw you and get your attention. But he's desiring you to repent of your sins, because the blood of Jesus must cleanse you before the Spirit of God enters you. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him, but you know him, for he dwells with you and he will be in you. He will be what? In you. John 16, while we're here, in verse 12. He said, I still have many things to say to you, but you can't bear them now because you won't understand them without the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is the one who interprets the Word of God. Amen? He interprets the truth. However, when he, the what? Spirit of truth has come, he will guide you into all truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come. He will glorify me, for he will take of what is mine and what? Declare to you, because he's come to bring you life and life abundantly. The devil has come to steal, kill, and destroy. So everybody got it. He's the Spirit of truth, born of the Spirit to become the epistle of truth and maintain it. 1 John chapter 4. Oh, it's good to hear the pages turning on a Tuesday night. Hallelujah. Influence. Ungodly influence. That's why we have two. Who told you that, right? To expose ungodly influence. Who told you that? 1 John chapter 4 and verse 1. Beloved, do not believe every spirit. That's it. But test the spirits. Hello. Whether they are of God. Well, how are you going to really test the spirit? You're going to know them by their fruit, aren't you? That's how you're going to know it. But because it says here, many false prophets have gone out into the world. That's many false Christians. And by this you know the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is of God. Now, I want you to understand something. Demons lie. So they'll confess anything that you want. Does everybody get it? But you're going to really know. Some of them will not confess that. But some of them will confess it and lie. Does everybody got it? They'll even lie and say that they're Christians. I mean, you know, hello. But the one thing that you'll realize is you'll know them by their fruit. Always know them by their fruit. How they speak, how they act, what they honor, what they worship. What kind of idols are in their life? You'll see, you'll know them by their fruit. In verse 3, and every spirit that does not confess that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is not of God. And this is the spirit of the Antichrist, which you have heard was coming and is now already in the world. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because he who is in you is greater than he who is in the world. They are of the world. Therefore, they speak as of the world. And the world hears them. That's how you'll know them, won't you? They'll agree with all the things that God disagrees with. We are of God. He who knows God hears us. He who is not of God does not hear us. And by this we know the spirit of truth and the spirit of error, or the spirit of the prince of power of error, or the spirit of Antichrist spirit. Remember, Antichrist spirit means against God's presence, truth, and power. The Antichrist. 1 John chapter 2. In verse 15. 1 John chapter 2, verse 10. Do not what? Do not love the world. Do not love the world. Do not love the world. Or the things in the world. In other words, do not entangle yourself with the affairs of the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. What's he talking about? For all that is in the world, the what? Lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world is passing away in the lust of it. But he who does the will of God abides forever. But he who does the will of God abides forever. But he who does the will of God abides forever. I'm going to say that one more time. But he who does the will of God abides forever. So if you're not doing the will of God, can you abide forever? You know, people have no idea that there is not an entrance available for them into eternal life, because they're still doing their will. This is a reality. There is a desire of God right now for all mankind to know the truth. But you can't give what you don't have. That's where it's a time. You must take the time to get so you can give it. Amen? Is everybody okay? Little children, it is the last hour. And you have heard that the Antichrist is coming. Even now, many Antichrists have come, by which we know that it is the last hour. Look around. Look what's going on in the world. Come on, didn't they take prayer out of school? Didn't they say you can't say Christmas? They should have sent a linebacker after them. They want to say Xmas? Wah! It says that they went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would have continued with us. But they went out that they might be manifest that none of them were really of us. But you have the anointing of the Holy One, and you know all things. I have not written to you because you don't know the truth, but because you know it, and that no lie is of the truth. In 1 John chapter 5. Everyone say, I'm a chosen vessel.
I'm a chosen
vessel. A written epistle. By the Spirit of the living God. I eat the word.
I become the word.
And I decree the word. Verse 18. 1 John chapter 5, 18. We know that whoever is born of God does not sin. But he who has been born of God keeps himself. He keeps himself from what? He keeps himself from sinning. Doesn't mean he won't make a mistake. But there's an area of a life of sin. He doesn't practice unrighteousness. He keeps himself untangled from the affairs of this world. He doesn't allow the cares of the world to make his decisions or feelings or emotions or influences or people or places or things. He allows truth to make his decision, and that's that. That's a true disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. And if you want to be a disciple of Jesus Christ, you've got to come to the end of you and allow truth to make your decision and not you. Oh, glory. Verse 19. Oh, no. Let's say this again. Verse 18. We know that whoever is born of God does not sin, but he who has been born of God keeps himself, and the wicked one does not touch him. So when a person isn't keeping themselves in the truth, what happens? The wicked one touches them. In reality, what begins to happen is because they're not seeing, they're not sensing the influence the wicked one will touch you through thoughts. That's the first place he touches you, is through your thoughts. And then he begins to touch you and everything. Then he gets you to touch everything. The next thing you know, 2 to 3 weeks later, you're right back where you started from. Verse 19. We know that we are of God, and the whole world lies under the sway of the wicked one. We know that the Son of God has come and has given us an understanding. This is how we get understanding, through the interpretation of the Spirit of God. You know, people are out there call themselves Christians and don't even read the Word of God. No understanding. They go to church every week, some dead church somewhere, and get nothing. They show up fulfilling their soulless emotion. Oh, I did good. I went to church. But you didn't get nothing. So you did no good at all. If you didn't get understanding when you come to fellowship, something ain't right. And we know that the Son of God has come and given us an understanding that we may know him who is true. And we are in him who is true, in his Son, Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life. Little children, keep yourselves from idols. How many of you know you can be the worst idol? 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Epistle of the Truth. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. In verse 17. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 17. Therefore, when you see therefore or if, it's a representation of if. In other words, if you cooperate, this is what's happening. It says, therefore, if you cooperate, if anyone is in Christ, he is a what? He's a new creation. Old things have passed away. In other words, old habits, old bondages, the old man is getting behind you, no longer before you. Behold, all things are becoming new. This is a reality. Now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ and has given us a ministry of reconciliation. That is, God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself. But now God is in you reconciling others to God. That is, God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself, not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us the word of what? Reconciliation. That's why we are the written epistle by the Spirit of God. We are the word of reconciliation. Now then, we are what? Ambassadors. We are ambassadors of the eternal kingdom, not ambassadors of the United States, Russia, Egypt, or anything else. You are an ambassador of the eternal realm of an eternal kingdom. You represent eternity. That's a heck of a responsibility. Not to be taken lightly. Not at all. God called you and me and chose us to be a representative of eternity. Think about that. What an honor. There isn't anything you and I earned. He said, you, come out of darkness and come into the marvelous light. Now learn so you don't burn. Because once I call you, he says, all hell is after you. I will protect you, but you must learn to protect yourself. Because there will be a time when I turn it over to you. Everybody got it? It says that he gave the earth to mankind. But they blew it. Now, we are ambassadors for Christ as though God were what? Come on, read it with me. Verse 20. Now then, We are ambassadors for Christ as though God were pleading through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him, as epistles of the truth. Epistles of truth. What an honor. It's amazing how many people don't take this serious. Nonchalantly. Yeah, man, I'm a Christian. Hallelujah. It's time to take this seriously. Because we are in a serious time. And we do not want to miss the move of God, what's happening. We want to be a part of that harvest. So your ministry is wherever you are, but you can't give what you don't have. So you need to get so you can give. Amen? Become that epistle that others will see Christ and not you. Praise God. Father, we thank you for your word. We are honored and blessed, and we honor and bless your holy name. Let the word that's been imparted in us tonight be sealed by the Holy Spirit, washed by the blood of Christ, healed by the stripes of Jesus in every part of our being. And let the anointing and the character of Christ Jesus as written epistles from your throne room allow and yield so that you may express yourself through us, because you're very good at it. And to Jesus Christ, the Lord, Savior, King of kings, and the great I am, be all honor, glory, and praise in Jesus' name. And everybody said amen.